Like her son before her, Miss Fox has been hit by a car.
Right.
Reg and Colin are on another emergency call out.
Yeah, he sort of appeared on the roof all the way along really slowly, then jumped down onto here, and then was sitting up there for about 10 minutes, just staring into space.
He's been hit by a car, didn't he?
He sort of just fell off and then crawled under.
His eyes were glazed, yeah?
Yeah, he was just sort of doing that.
The way he's breathing, he's...
What, he's not good?
Not good, no. Not the way he's breathing. He's breathing like that. I can see that from here. Plus the fact he's moving his head, which is probably concussion anyway. Right, but we've got to come to some arrangements here.
Well, I don't really want you to cut my deck, to be honest.
No, I don't want you to cut the deck. It's, otherwise, if he dies under there, you're going to have one hell of a smell.
Yeah.
Do you know, if you go to the car, the back of the car, you'll see that blue bag?
Yeah.
The shell one? In that, it's got all tools in it.
You say, only got cordless?
No. You'll never get them out of an ordinary screwdriver, Reg. Because
yeah.
That's a tantalised treated timber.
Big old screws.
Nanny, that's it. You're doing it. Good hit, Cole. Now take the lift. Careful, careful. Right, hold on. Steady. One rescued fox.
Here we go.
Go on, Rich. In he comes.
No, you haven't put the paper in.
Oh.
No, darling. Okay. I gotcha. Okay, darling. That's a good girl.
Only the vet can save Miss Fox.
You may have to be put to sleep. It all depends on what's the matter with her. But it don't look too good at the moment.
For 10 days we were not feeding her, and whether she's gone to pastures greener to get more food from someone else and given up on us, we don't know, but she's disappeared. We've got her last appearance on video.
What? Oh, here.
This is where she shows really how confident she is with us. I am actually sitting out in the cold on the front step with some enticing chicken bones, and she's lurking just a little way away, and I am using my cajoling foxy voice and calling little Miss Fox, and in the end she comes to within about 2 feet of me. Little Miss Fox just was so bold about it all.
It's a pet, almost.
Swiss rolls, fairy cakes. Chocolate Swiss roll, jam Swiss roll. You know, as you see, they're so well fed. That's what they get. That plus their cakes and that, what I'm going to feed them on.
Unknown to Alan and June, Miss Fox is convalescing at Reg's fox sanctuary.
Oh, the other side? They can't see your face that side. No! This side. Let them see your face, come on. Okay. Let's stroke this one. She's okay, look. She will not bite. No, no, stroke her. I'm sorry. You'll be okay. It's unbelievable, isn't it? Why people got to be afraid of them. And why they harm them. It's unbelievable. They get persecuted quite a bit. Poisoned, hit by cars, hunted, everything. Oh, no. Come on. Ben?
Howard seeing a family friend, a farmer in Oxfordshire. He wants to replace some of his lost chickens, and he's also getting some country wisdom, free of any urban sentiment.
When the hounds came regularly, we didn't have any fox shooting done, but yeah. Now, apart from if there was a problem, you know,
yeah.
But now we tend to actually have the more or less a shooting policy, and if there's a fox around, it gets shot, you know.
Yeah. Oh. Quite easy, yeah. There's one. Nothing here anyway. Fantastic.
Howard has cornered 8 new hens, ready to lay.
Hello. Oh, this is a big one. Oh, she's pretty. Isn't that a pretty chickenry? That's a pretty one as well. I have to think of a whole load of new set of names.
Oh, God, it smells foul. It's definitely got essence of lion dung, seems to contain ammonia.
To give his new birds a fighting chance, Howard's trying out a new humane deterrent.
Perhaps this stuff will prevent the wretched foxes having a go at my lovely girls.
Just off Church Street, there's a derelict house, an ideal location for an earth, a place for timid vixen to start her family. Her pregnancy will last for 53 days, and Railway Fox will stay with her until the cubs are born in spring. Now, he forages for them both, and he knows where there's chicken tonight.
Came down this morning to feed them, give them water. And look at that. Things. Well, it certainly shows all those urban furry fox lovers what they can really do, doesn't it? There are 10 of them in there, and they're all dead, every one of them. That's the favourite Japanese one. Its belly's been ripped open. You can see the eggs that it was going to lay for us. It's pretty ghastly. I don't know if they're any inside. God, the heads over here. Ugh. There are 9 corpses here out of 10 birds that were here. And it's just literally taken the heads off all of them. Kill them. Only the Japanese one has been broken open to eat in part. And intestines are lying around and that sort of stuff. They probably did it last night. We were out last night. So nobody heard or saw anything. But that's definitely the way they got in and out. And they've actually managed to break the wire. That's extraordinary. And they actually have burst through the wire there.
It's weird how they killed them.
It's horrible. Completely unnecessary. The fact their heads are so far away from their bodies as well, which is disgusting.